In this video, we will discuss about space and time. In this three-dimensional world, we can consider space and time to be a fixed framework against which we can study motion of moving bodies. To describe the motion of object in space, we wish to find its position at different instant of time. For this, it is useful at this point to introduce the concept of frame of reference attached to a rigid body and describe the position of the object relative to it. A rigid body is actually a body that does not deform or change shape under any force. And frame of reference means a system relative to which observations are taken. Or you can define a set of axes with reference to which position or motion of a particle is described. Here you can see X, Y, and Z are set of axes with reference to which if you have a particle at point P, then you can describe the position of that particle with respect to the origin of this system. So to define the position vector for this object at point P, we can write a position vector as R is equal xi plus yj plus zk, where I, j, k are the unit vectors along x, y, and z axes. Next, to find the position of the object at different time, we write the position vector r as a function of time t. This means that at particular instant of time, the observer at origin may take a clock to measure the time of any event. The position and time of any event may then be specified with respect to this frame by x, y, z and time t. Now we can find the velocity and acceleration of the object at different instant of time. And for that, simply, we just need to take the first derivative of this position vector and which will give us the velocity at different axes. And we can also take the acceleration of, and we can also find the acceleration of the object by taking the second derivative of this position vector. And you can see here, along all three axes, we can find the components of acceleration. So in conclusion, we can say that the position of the object at any point of its path, at a particular time, expressed in terms of four coordinates, x, y, z, and time t, in this given reference system, which may also be called as space-time reference system. So this is all about this topic. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please share and subscribe to my channel.